There is a convention by IMO that is called the Hong Kong International Convention for the Safe and Environmentally Sound Recycling of Ships. So I thought I'll just today I'll present the information and what IMO has to say about this convention. So this convention was adopted on 15th of May 2009 and it had to come into force 24 months after ratification by 15 states, and that also represented 40% of world merchant shipping by gross tonnage. The third condition for it was that the combined maximum annual ship recycling volume should not be not less than 3% of their combined tonnage. So it is yet to come into force. It has not met some of these conditions. So the Hong Kong Convention is aimed at ensuring that ships, when being recycled after reaching the end of their operational lives, do not pose any unnecessary risk to human health and safety or to the environment. The convention was adopted in Hong Kong and was developed with input from the IMO member states, of course, as well as some non-governmental organizations in cooperation with the International Labour Organization, that is ILO, and the parties to the Basel Convention on the Control of Transboundary Movements of Hazardous Waste and Their Disposal. It intends to address all the issues around ship recycling, including the fact that ships sold for scrapping may contain environmentally hazardous substances such as asbestos, heavy metals, hydrocarbons, ozone depleting substances and others. Because as you probably know that a lot of this insulation in the ship is created using asbestos sometimes, especially the olden ships. And there could be other material, like the refrigeration plants could be containing chlorofluorocarbons or CFCs, and that comprise of ozone depleting substances. So these are some of the examples that may be there when the ship is being recycled. And if it is not properly recycled, not properly scrapped or destroyed, then this has an impact on the environment. So the convention attempted to address concerns about the working as well as environmental conditions in many of the world's ship recycling facilities. Regulations in the new convention also cover the design, construction, operation, and preparation of ships so as to facilitate safe and environmentally sound recycling without compromising the safety and operational efficiency of ships. The operation of ship recycling facilities in a safe and environmentally sound manner and the establishment of an appropriate enforcement mechanism for ship recycling, incorporating certification as well as reporting requirements. Ships to be sent for recycling will be required to carry out an inventory of all hazardous materials, which is specific to each ship. An appendix to the convention provides a list of what is considered as hazardous materials, the installation or use of which is prohibited or restricted in shipyards, ship repair yards, and ships of parties to this convention. Ships will be required to have an initial survey to verify the inventory of hazardous materials, renewal surveys during the life of the ship, and a final survey prior to recycling. Now, this is only for those ships which have been registered under the flag state of the signatory parties who have ratified this convention, who have complied with this convention. Ship recycling yards will be required to provide a ship recycling plan to specify the manner in which each individual ship will be recycled depending on its particulars and inventory. Now, of course, this plan will be taking into consideration the any kind of impact on the environment and the prevention to do so. Parties will be required to take effective measures to ensure that ship recycling facilities under their jurisdiction comply with the requirements of this convention. series of guidelines are being finalized to assist in the convention's implementation.